Only a few of you probably know this, but I've got a connection to Japan, as of my mother being Japanese, and therefore I've been to Japan quite often with my family to visit my grandparents there and for holiday. In fact, I started to become interested in making videos back in 2016, the last time I was in Japan. Anyway, today's video's topic begins a few weeks ago when I was scrolling through Instagram and came across a photo from Japan. I looked at the photograph in admiration and began to wallow in nostalgia, thinking about the times when I was in Japan and how much I adored that country. Suddenly I thought it'd be great to find some photographers based in Japan and follow them for a regular dose of Japan nostalgia. So I went to Instagram's search bar and looked for hashtag JapanPhoto, hashtag JapanPhotography, and a little later I was scrolling through hashtag JapanOnFilm. This is where I found a few Japanese photographers who seemed to enjoy documenting moments of their life, or simply shooting things they thought was visually interesting. I loved the casual and often personal style of the photographs I found, and ended up following a few accounts, three of which I want to share with you in this video. So today I'm showing you three kinda random Japanese film photographers. So what do I mean by random, you may be asking? The three photographers are not well-established photographers, I believe. This is just me assuming, I might be totally wrong, but the collection of photos the three post appears strongly personal in my perspective. It looks like they're having a great time with photography, documenting moments of their life, and sharing their shots online for Japan nostalgia-greedy people like me to admire. So let's check out the first photographer, Yuta Ogura, I believe is his name. Yuta is a spectator. He shoots a wide range of scenes and objects he encounters in his life. His subjects range from the beauty of the trees in spring to some intriguing architecture he finds and or some flowers. Something I noticed and I think is quite interesting is that he stays anonymous in his photography. We never get to see a self-portrait or even a shadow of Yuta. He also rarely shows his social environment or people in general. I found this photo of a baseball team, which might or might not be a hint of the kind of person he is. This anonymity gives the photographs this sort of mystery, the question of who was behind the camera to press the shutter. Mostly, his photographs show his perspective on the beauty of the everyday. This shot here, looking over the city, gives me the impression of a memory. Maybe he was walking home from work and appreciated the last light of the day, so he decided to get out his camera and get a photo of this scenery. This photograph shows a street that gives a filled impression. Not particularly busy, there are only a few people to see, but the various signs, colorful leaves, and bushes as a whole make this photograph look a little busy to me, and it gives me many details to look at. The vibe I perceive when looking at these is a sort of personal documentary vibe. I don't exactly know why I feel that, but I'm liking it. The fact that the photographer is unknown supports my own imagination, and I begin to think of the situation he was in while shooting these photographs, and for some reason, I always feel like these shots were a casual documentation of his surroundings and his life. Similar to the possible explanation previously, this photograph lets me imagine the moment he was in. For me, this looks like the kind of place he'd go after a hard day of work. After completing his tasks, whatever he does, he might have thought to himself that he doesn't want to bother to cook himself a dinner at home, so he'll eat out on his way home. That's what brought him here, where he ordered a beer and some food, and then while enjoying his bottle, he watched the cook in front of him impressively handle the fire. Yuta must have thought this looks cool, so he got this photo. Do you know what I mean when I say these photographs look rather personal to me? They seem like his own unique way to express his appreciation for the good moments in life. Every photograph gives me the impression that he saw the pictured scene or object and decided to document the appreciation he felt for what he saw. This regular and seemingly intentional note-taking of the sights he appreciates results in a beautiful, intriguing collection of photography that allows viewers like me to get an insight into his unique life. Additionally, he leaves enough room for interpretation so that we can imagine ourselves what his life might be like. And please remember, this is all just me guessing and interpreting. Maybe Yuta just completely randomly shoots stuff unintentionally, but what I've said is merely my personal interpretation and impression of the insight I'm getting. One more aspect of Yuta's photography I would like to mention is the medium. By shooting on film, his photographs of course have a certain aesthetic, and I believe that also adds to the feelings I get from viewing his gallery. Let's move on to the next photographer, Kenta. Thank you. Kenta is also a Japanese photographer who tends to shoot casual life documentary photography. Unlike Yuta, however, he's not anonymous. He's even got a photo of himself on his page. According to his Instagram bio, he lives in Tokyo and shoots with a Konica C35EF and an Olympus XA2. Not that it matters, but I think it's fun to collect a few hints to imagine the kind of person Kenta might be. According to the hashtags below his posts, he mainly shoots Kodak Gold, which results in an overall rather warm-looking feed. His subjects range from cityscapes, restaurants, and many photos of this woman. I'm guessing this is his girlfriend or wife. So as you see, Kenta's gallery is similarly personal to Yuta's photography, but Kenta gives us much more insight in the person behind the camera. His photos give me personally the impression that he enjoys to travel to various places in Japan with his girlfriend or wife and collect memories which he likes to capture photographically. While Yuta's photography felt more like a documentation of the everyday, I find Kenta's photos to express a more explorative sense. His photographs look more like memories from travels with his partner, nights out, or a day in the park. They definitely emit a sense of nostalgia and carefree times, a bit as if this were a gallery to compile his best memories. This photo of Mount Fuji is one of my favorite photographs in his feed, and I think it perfectly represents what I explained above. I imagine Kenta sitting in the train together with his partner on the way to a weekend trip. Both are watching the houses whiz by, and behind the city in the distance, Mount Fuji rises above the landscape. Kenta feels excited to embark on this new trip, and decides to capture the scenery out of the window to represent the excitement he feels. Again, this is just my imagination, and how the photo might have been created, I'm probably entirely wrong, but I suppose you understand the vibes I get when looking at Kenta's photography. I think especially the aerial kind of photos hold within a sort of touristic nature. I mean this in a good way. It's the kind of photo you would take when you're somewhere you don't usually find yourself at, and therefore you document the uniqueness of the site. Here's another photo I want to highlight, which I really like. Maybe my enjoyment for this photo comes from the fact that I can relate to why Kenta might have shot this. My interpretation here is that this was on a trip to a small town, and this photo was taken at the end of the day while waiting for the train to take them back to Tokyo. Seeing as Kenta is used to Tokyo and the incredible amount of people everywhere in that city, the emptiness of this train station was captivating. To sum things up, I think Kenta's photography holds a lot of nostalgia, satisfaction, and personal character, which for me as the viewer feels in a way honest, and they make me long for more carefree times. I've got one more photographer for you in this video. She's actually not Japanese, but she lives in Japan. Her Instagram tag is Very Merry, and her name in the bio is Mojito, which I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing correctly, I hope I am. She writes that she is Spanish and lives in Tokyo. Her feed is a beautiful variety of street photography, abstract structures, minimalism, and an occasional double exposure. Overall, Mojito's photography simply captures the aesthetics of Japan. She shoots small streets, details of those streets, the seat in a train, or a guy taking a selfie with the cherry blossoms. When we compare the three photographers, there's one striking aspect that makes Mojito's photography interesting in a different way than Yuta and Kenta. She's not Japanese. The fact that she's European, which is far from Japan, gives her perspective a whole different kind of value. These are European eyes photographing Japan, not Japanese eyes, which I believe look at everything differently. While Yuta and Kenta are looking for subjects to photograph in the country and culture they've grown up in, and in the infrastructure they are closely familiar with, Mojito has a whole new perspective on entirely everything. When looking through her photos, I've noticed that she often chooses to shoot things I believe I would have definitely shot as well. I've been to Japan a couple times, but I've always lived in Austria, so pretty much everything over there still intrigues me simply by being so different to what I'm used to. And Mojito captures just that perfectly. To demonstrate my point and how Mojito often seems to have the exact same thoughts I would have had in her situation, I'll read the caption of this photograph to you. I took this photo a couple months ago. I was walking around Shimokitazawa and I remember the light that day was the best. And then I found this wall with the air conditioner things and the cute blue tiles and I thought this is cool. I like this photo, it's from one of the last rolls that I developed. I totally relate to the attraction to this scene and I think it's beautiful to see someone else walking through Tokyo doing exactly what I would like to be doing. Apart from her choices of the subject matter, I think she's generally an incredible photographer with an extra eye for color. Again, I don't know how intentional these aspects of her photography are, but I'm explaining what I see and I imagine when looking at her photography. So I have found that she often makes an incredible use of color. Color isn't just part of her photos, oftentimes the color is the photo. Here's an example. I love how basically the whole photo is pink. The only point of contrast is the gray camera, but still you see exactly what the scene is showing. Or see this photograph. It shows this hoop, the cherry blossom tree behind, and the sky at the top. What makes this photo special for me personally is the enhanced separation of the three elements, thanks to the strongly different colors green, pink, and blue. So to sum things up, Mojito creates beautiful photography picturing the aesthetics of Japan from the eyes of a Spanish person. That's it, those were the three kind of random Japanese film photographers I wanted to show you. It's not so long ago that I found these accounts, and since taking an even closer look at the photography to make this video, I found all the more appreciation for these three photographers. So here's me sharing what I appreciate about them. I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, leave a like, it helps the channel to grow, consider subscribing if you haven't yet, and I'll hopefully see you again next week in the next video. Until then, goodbye.